Okay, if you were once like me, I've seen this probably thumbnails of some YouTube channels how to create something like this, and you're wondering, was it created on Pixel Lab? Now, I was also confused and I discovered it was a mock-up. So I'll be teaching you how you can also achieve the same mock-up effect. Without any further ado, let's just go straight to the tutorial. Now, you'll be creating it using your smartphone, but Pixel Lab can't do it. If there's any application that's close enough to do something like this, will be PixArt, but we'll be making use of Photopea. Now, Photopea is just like online Photoshop. You can edit, can create something just the way Photoshop does using your phone if you know how to use Photopea. Now, but in this particular tutorial, we'll be editing a PSD file. There is the link to download the PSD file will be in the description below. So just go. So the first thing is come to File, Open. So I'll be trying to locate the file where I kept it. So I kept it in a safe place where I can easily get it here. So it is here. So this one will be making use of free DVD CD player. So it's going to take a while for it to load. Now it has finished loading. So you just come here. It is hidden. I clicked, so that's where I clicked on. Now you can see they are now visible. So you come here, click on this arrow. So it's gonna show you now. So this is for the disk, this is for the CD. So I'm just gonna come back, go back to edit and undo, because I actually tampered with it. So I'll double click on this area, tap it twice, this area here, place this cover, I tap, double click on it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to turn off everything. I don't need it. I'm going to turn off every single thing. So I don't need any of them. You can delete it if that's your choice. So the next thing is I'll just come to Open and Place. That will bring in the one I want to make use of. So I'll come to Recent. Okay, so now this is I shouldn't use this image because of the size. It's taking time, that's why I shouldn't have used it. But it is done anyway. Now so then I'll just click on this and cancel it. Then make sure you click on that OK. Now it's not going to work because I forgot to do something. So I'll double click on it again. Now please just don't close it from there. See the same mistake the same thing I just experienced. Now that's what you're going to experience if you're always doing it like that. So you just come here, come to Open and Place. I did that by mistake, but I just guess you'll be learning from it. Now okay, let me just show you how you should have done it. Now this is the same image. Now open and place it there. It's going to take a while and it's going to load. Okay, so the next thing, you just come here, save smart objects. Make sure you save smart objects. If not, when you fall through that process, it's not going to save. Save smart objects. Okay, now it is saved. Now but I can feel like a bit of glitch there by the side, so let me click on transform control and adjust the size a bit. Okay, so let me be sure it's at the center. Okay, now we'll still come here, save smart object. Make sure you're saving smart object. I noticed there was actually some space behind. I'll click back on this transform control to uncheck it. So I'll just click on this. So you can see that place has changed. So the next one is this particular one for the disks. I'll just double click on it the same way we double clicked on it. Then hide everything. Sorry about this. Should put up that telegram in a bit. so just come here and hide everything. Now when I hid everything, it became plain. So I'll come to open and place. I'll bring the same image. Okay, now if you join me, please subscribe. So I will just maybe just draw it by this side. And okay. Okay, so I'm done. So I'll just save smart objects. Alright, so it is done. So I'll just click on cancel. You can see now it has changed. Now, so you can, if you want the background, you can keep the background. So I'll just click on this place. Now it has I'll just come here, click on that eyes. It's going to hide it if you don't want the background. But if you want it, you can keep it. But I don't want it. I want to create my own background. I want to use it on my own background. Now if you notice, if I zoom in, it has some shadow effects just to make it feel real. That you're placing it on something. So you can just come here, click on export as. If you click on, let's try JPEG, but I don't strongly recommend you use JPEG because JPEG gives you background itself. They are not transparent. It's going to give you its own background. Let me try and see. It gives us a white background, so we don't want that. It gives us a white background, so we want export as PNG. Now PNG is not going to give us background, it's going to be transparent. So you can see that it indicates that it is transparent. So now it's giving this the size that I'll now come to use save. Now it's going to give me like an ad. It's going to run an ad for me about 27, 30 minutes, 30 seconds rather. So once the ad has finished running, it will start downloading itself. I'm not a premium user. I don't use it anyway. Okay. Please subscribe to my channel. You can also watch my other videos. Alright, so it is downloading and voila! It has finished downloading. So this is it. You can now create your own background and put it there. Probably if you like the other background, so you just come here, click on this and just make this background visible. And the best way of exporting, now that it has background, you can export as PNG too, but just export as JPEG. Alright, so that will be all for this particular tutorial. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.